What is going on, everyone, and welcome to the Stock Trends channel. So in this video, we're going to be going over ticker symbol RKT, Rocket Companies, also known as Rocket Mortgage. So this company just released earnings. We want to talk about this price action, which is very volatile. We had highs here after hours of $22.60 and some lows here of $20.51, and we bounced off of that and come back and then bounced again. Now we're kind of slowly steadying out right here. We had a pretty solid day today if you were to catch some of this move towards the end of the day. However, earnings are now released. We have that data, so let's take a look at what we have. Third quarter results are out. Increased GAAP net income 500% year over year, $3 billion. They also announced a $1 billion share repurchase authorization. I think that takes place today. The CEO had some great words talking about how they were able to manage through the pandemic, how they're helping Americans buy, refinance home, and provide relief. Which also, one thing to note here too, is that we're gonna have to watch stimulus. We're gonna have to be very careful of stimulus here, because that will in turn affect how Rocket Mortgage does. That will play a role if we get stimulus now, later, how much money we get, what does that actually entail, what does that actually mean in terms of rent protection, in terms of different things regarding the housing industry, forbearance, in terms of things like that. So continuing down, firing on all cylinders, looking forward to a strong end of the year. All great things, okay, said by those, you know, part of the company, which makes sense. They're going to, you know, they're going to talk, you know, nicely about their company despite what potentially may be looming down here. So we're going to talk about some of these numbers, especially the balance sheet, because you guys can look this up. This is in the earnings report. This is public information. We can keep going down. What I want to talk about is some of the highlights, and then we'll jump into the balance sheet really quick, because there's a lot of stuff here. I don't want to waste too much of your time with just going over all this information and just reading it out blindly. Total revenue growth 186% compared to the third quarter of 2019. That's a good sign. You like to hear that. Adjusted revenue by 163% compared to 2019. And this is despite increasing expenses by 46%. They increased other income by over 140% year over year. And then continuing down the list, we see that they are again named number one in the nation for client satisfaction in the mortgage origination by J.D. Power. 11th year in a row that they have earned this award. There's that $1 billion share repurchase program that is effective, of course, today, which is November 10th, 2020. Moving down the line here, net client retention rate 92% and client refinance recapture rate of 82%. Now, one thing, like I was talking about before, when it comes to stimulus and comes to the tougher part of the overall financial and the overall economic situation that we're dealing with right now, 4.1% of their portfolio or total clients are on a forbearance plan that is due to the virus. But they do note that this does compare favorably to the overall industry figure of 5.8%. So that's a good sign, at least for Rocket Mortgage as of right now. Small, but a good sign. Now to the balance sheet highlights. So in terms of cash and equivalents, this is $3,485, and this is all, these numbers are all in millions, by the way, which is a significant bump from about a year ago. In terms of equity, just about double what they had just about 1 year ago. So now let's take a look at the chart and see how things are looking based on the chart, where we can find support, resistance right now. So we're recurving a little bit back on up, and things will be a little bit volatile here in after hours. Things will continue to change and be fluid. It's, you know, trading, of course, is an art, not an exact science for those looking for support and resistance. It doesn't have to hold a certain support. It doesn't have to hold a certain resistance. It doesn't mean that's the end all be all, but it can be a good guide. So taking a look at the daily chart, let's zoom in and see what we've been seeing. So what we saw was Rocket came down to about 1750 or so, pretty much the lows that we can see on the chart. And then it recovered pretty nicely off of that level, heading back up over 20. And it was over 22 today. And now the question is going to be, what happens next? Does Rocket consolidate? Does it push higher in the coming days? Does it fall back to the bottom? Well, we can identify, it looks as if $20 is an area of potential support based off of holding up right in here. And based off of, you know, right about here, we held up a couple times. So $20 should be a decent area of support if we do start coming down. And if we fall below that, of course, we'd want to look to that 1750 or so as an area of support, as that's where we came down to before. We roughly came down to around 18 or so here, and then 1750 or so back in the first day we were trading. And in terms of the upside, it looks as if Based on some of these tops right in here, it looks like $24 will be a key level to break to the upside. And then after that, it looks like some of these wicks here to about $25. So that $24 to $25 range to the upside will be important. As we can see based on this, we had a little bit of a trend line going, crack that trend and move to the downside. So we can get rid of that for right now, but it looks like $24, $25 to the upside. And then after that, it looks like as if we would be looking to some of these highs right here as new resistance and some of these lows, which will put us in that $27 range. So those are the areas we're looking for. Hopefully this was helpful. Please make sure to jump down below, subscribe to the channel, hit the thumbs up button. Super short, up-to-date videos just like this coming all the time. And also while you're down there, make sure to grab your 3 free stocks with the link in the description and pinned comment. That's this desktop platform that we're using to chart and to show all the data here. This is the Webull platform. You can get 3 free stocks if you deposit $100. Hopefully you take advantage of that. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.